So I'll do a count to lead it in. One, two, three, four. Prejudice to guitars that have plastic backs. Tighter sound. Tighter sound. Tighter sound. Tighter sound. Feel free to experiment around with it. Things I should mention now is that, first off, neither the rhythm through there nor the improvising part over the rhythm were what I would consider the ideal, but I think you get the point nonetheless.
Hey, what's up, everyone? How y'all doing today? We got an active chat already. We're all hanging out. I'll tell y'all, there's not a whole lot going on today. I'm just hanging out at home. I think I mentioned this last time, but I kind of cleared off my Tuesdays, hoping that I'd have more time to stream if I wanted to keep going or if I got other work to get done. I have time to do it. I also wanted to say, too, if you guys noticed, we had a little bit of downtime on the website. There's a couple of people that emailed me, and I know they were of the super fan variety. So if you happen to see that the website was down, all of that's back and functional, operating as usual. So I'm sorry if you experienced any trouble this weekend. Cool. All right. And we got our first suggestions. Hey, Marcel, man, you helped me get through lockdown with all these great videos. No problem, man. Thanks for being a member. I appreciate it. Tony Rice, Blue Rail, or Chain? I know, that lo-fi tune. I mean, it's weird because I made it, but I'll admit that I jam to it now and then. Exactly. That's Blue Rail or Chain, though. I think the tab for that's already on the already on the website, Stephen. So if you want Blue Rail or Chain, you should go check that out. Lonesome Wind Blues. I think I have to say I'm not familiar with that tune. I might have to go check it out. Hey Russell, how you doing? Yeah, I already did Blue Rail or Chain. I appreciate the help, man. It's hard to remember sometimes. And I've mentioned this to people before too, but by no means is all the stuff that I've transcribed on the website. There's just so much to dig through. There's probably a good 1,000 transcriptions on my computer. And I don't know, maybe 60% of them are on the website. You guys know how long it takes me to get stuff on there too when we do these live streams. These strings feel a little dead to me. Wonder if this one feels better. Maybe a little bit. I don't know. I might just be confused because I was playing a lot of electric guitar last night. Yeah, is Lonesome Wind Blues, is it that just like the jam now? We got Stephen Wright and Tony Rice with a hangover asking for it. And Gary. Oh, everyone wants to hear this tune. Yeah, we can do that. I love that. I love when you guys all agree. Everyone wants the exact same thing. Yeah, hell yeah, let's do it. In the words of that one stream, hell yeah. It's a great break. The version is great with Don Reno. All right, so you're telling me I'm looking for Don Reno, Tony Rice, Lonesome Wind Blues. Let's make it happen. Paranoid about playback speed. Like, am I listening to it too slow, too fast?
I hear the wind a blowing through the lonesome pine, and I know my love has gone blue. I hear the wind a blowing through the lonesome pine. That's why I'm
This tune's a bop. I like this.
I hear the
I assume that's the break you guys want, yeah? This is the break? Tell me I'm right. Cool. So if that's the break, we'll check that out. Mickey said something else. Mickey said, you know how I always offer an idea and you at least listen to it? All right, let's do it. In a Stained Rag. Gabe. Let's see, am I looking for... Yeah, this must be it. That's such a Mickey lick. That was a great break. It's actually a Gabe lick. That's good. You're just a thief, man. That's a great break, man. I wonder if we could just do maybe like the first part of this or like the second part of this. In any case, we can't start with that. Let's go with the first suggestion we got. We were supposed to do this Lonesome Wind Blues first. So let's start there. Hey Marcel, my uncle did a couple bluegrass albums in the 1970s. They're both on YouTube, and one of them has a short little intro guitar break that I can't figure out. Could you tab it? Man, that's cool. Well, let's do that too. It's like we've already decided what we're going to do all day. All right, let's start with the Tony Rice. Let's start with this Lonesome One Blues. We got to do this first, and then we'll hit some of these other things. Mickey's got a tune. Tony Rice with the Hangover's got a tune. We're going to hit them. Okay. Let's get transcribing. My love has gone blue. I hear the wind a blowing through the lonesome pine. That's why I'm blue, love so blue. So hey Tony Rice of the Hangover, it might not let you post the link to the video in the chat. You have my email though, you can just email it to me. Let me know when you sent it. Let's see, is there a capo going on here? Oh, hey, you know what I gotta point out before I get to the bottom of this mystery? Look who uploaded this video. Our buddy James Stillner. Yeah, James Stillner is super cool. If you've never checked out his YouTube channel, go check it out. He's really into a lot of traditional aspects of bluegrass. He does a really good, like George Scheffler kind of impersonation. The Mountain Dew Break, like the Stanley Brothers one, he does that super well too. That's Bill Napier. He does that really well. Really cool guitar player, this guy. And he's got a bunch of old bluegrass footage on his channel. So check him out for sure. I did an interview with him for the cross-picking video I did too. If you want to see me and him hang out and chat, that's on my video called What is Cross-Picking? Anyway. All right, let's just write it as if there's no capo thing going on, and if we gather more evidence, we'll make it happen. It sounded like maybe that was happening like quietly. And of course, like always, I gotta point it out. You go to the settings wheel, playback speed. You can change how fast it's going. People always ask me how I do that. There's no big secret. It's built into YouTube. It's probably a little slow. Interesting. So, down. Da da ba do da 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 da. Oh, we're just getting into the swing of things, guys. We gotta wake up. Okay, cool. You know the drill. I like to write when the break starts here. And I like to get at least four measures on a line. It helps me think. See the form of the song. So something like this helps me like visualize what I'm doing. Cool. Cool. Same little kickoff phrase. Sounds like he's going into this too. Let's see, I'm catching back up with you, Tony Rise of the Hangover. They're both albums, not individual songs, but descriptions of the song types written in them. Cool. The album is called The Floyd County Boys Rollin' On. It's a blue album cover with orange lettering and a band on the front. It should be the first thing that comes up. Cool, 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 cool. We had two albums, but this one has the break in it. Oh man, Gary remembers them. That's very cool. Gary, you're a champ. That's so cool. Thank you. So it seems like it's this measure again. That makes me happy, guys. I can't believe that just happened. Oh yeah, my family was that band. I remember that band. That's super cool. Quick slide. Tied across the byline, it sounds like. Something like that. Thank you, Mr. Hangover. Love it. I guess I should know what chord that C9, man. It sounds more like this, like a S7 shape to me. Like, I hear that E flat on top of the chord, so it can't be C9. Hear that, it's the top voicing and he keeps hitting that F note. I think he does do a C9 right here though. Maybe he's not quite catching that bass note. Maybe not. Scratch this. Yeah, I hear you, Mickey. You're like, what key am I in? I'll happily admit that even though I wrote this kickoff, which is very much not G, I was confused for a second. Like over here, I was like, man, what key are we in? What's happening? Yeah, it sounds like he catches like another string a little bit, something like that. I don't know what it is exactly, it doesn't matter. Da, 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 da. phrase starts over here. Something like that, maybe. Pull off. Sometimes these phrases make a lot more sense as soon as you get started, but when you're trying to get them started, you're like, what's happening? This was a pull-off. One of these has to be a minor third. Are both of them? I hear a really light strum in the background. Yeah, Mickey, I need you paying attention so you can keep me honest. I guess this is ringing out. Da 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 do da. Definitely dominant seventh up there. Escape him. Oh, he goes all the way down to G, right? He goes down like quite a ways before he actually escapes. I thought it was going to be so much sooner. It's like all the way over there. Crazy. This, I think that's blue. Gee, how do I want to do this? I guess that might be the best way to write that rhythm. It's not my favorite. Not my favorite way to write that. Cool, I'm going to turn off the sheet music, try to get this all on one page, and let's see if I can read it. Counting. Thank you. It's kind of like, just this look bothers me. I really want him to do this. Almost like that would be the... I feel like he wanted to do that both times. I'm projecting my emotions onto Tony Rice. Big strokes are a mess. Everything Zealous is a mess too, but it's enough for you to get the idea. Hey, what's up? Thanks for subscribing there, Christy. I appreciate it. I just like hearing that sound effect, man. I mean, it's really about the sound effect for me, but getting more people subscribed is just, you know, a side effect of the sound effect, if you will. All right, here's the big strokes. Here's the pick strokes. I'm not sure. I think this is a pull off. Cool. Of course, we'll clean this up. This will be available on the site in a little while. I should probably put chords in here too. I feel like whenever this is like a curse that I have for myself. Whenever I put the chords in a live stream, I mess them up. Like I've psyched myself out now. I'm like, I'm sure I'm gonna mess up the chords, so I don't even want to, but let's try. Sounded like we had an F, G, C, like we had something like that. Maybe I didn't jinx myself this time. Let's see. Lonesome Wind Blues. We'll label this as Tony's Break. And then we can get the As Performed By in there. And we're there. We did it, gang. All right, remember, save your work as always. Save your work. One of these days, I'm going to be saving my work on stream, and everything is just going to crash. My old computer is just going to explode. I saw a comment on a YouTube video recently that was talking about Guitar Pro crashing. Someone was saying, man, whenever I open Guitar Pro, it crashes. And I've never had that experience. I don't know why, but that is not the experience that I've had with Guitar Pro, like, at all. It's actually one of the more stable programs that I work with. I feel like if you want to talk about crashing, you should talk about, like, anything in the Adobe, like, Creative Cloud group of programs, like Premiere Pro, Photoshop, Illustrator. Those things crash all the time. Okay, wait, let's do this. Mr. Hangover, as they say. Let's do this one next. because you're intriguing me with this story. I find it interesting. See if I can track down this song real quick. He said it's the blue album with orange lettering. Got it. Got it. Okay, cool. And you said the song that I want the intro to on the album is called Freight Rider Blues. Freight Rider Blues. Dixie Darling is another one. Let's look at it.
My Dixie Darling.
Sweet. All right, this is the one you asked about specifically, though. You're looking for Freight Rider Blues, right? So maybe let's start with this thing. And yeah, let's see if we can find the answer real quick. I don't think this will take more than a second. Let's go over here. We probably got to figure out what keyword. C Maybe I should be writing this as quarter notes. Well, cross that bridge later. Yeah, this should definitely all be quarter notes. Let's back up. All right, cool. So there's a tiny little strum here. Let's get at all the details, right? This is like a simpler one. So let's see if we can get it like real good. So I heard the same little strum. This time it sounded like he was catching all these strings, though. So I like to put these strums in parentheses just so people know they're not quite as heavily played. I'm not sure I ever hear that F on top. Cool. I think this is what you're looking for, my dude.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Why we got it so slow? Let's speed it up at least a little bit. Bro, one too many measures. Sounds like we're going to do an E chord. Wait, what key are we in? I won't bother with that this time. Maybe 2 inches of this. Yeah, cool. And then we're going to a G chord after this. This is that guitar kick if you're struggling with it. See if there's anything else here.
Listen to the rattle of that
old... Yeah, man. This is that guitar intro. Cool. All right, let's play it. Let's prove we did it. There it is. All right, Mr. Hangover. I hope that helps, my dude. Let's write down that's Freight Rider Blues. Floyd County Boys. And right here, we're gonna write guitar kick. Cool, man. I hope that helps figure out that that kickoff for this tune from your uncle's old band. This is a fun one to do. Not too bad. As always, if you email me, I'll send you this one, dude. I know this is kind of a personal one, so this might not end up on the website, but that was fun, man. save your work. The Floyd County Boys. Oh, hey, what's up, Mike? How about swinging a 9-pound hammer, cool trad guitar? Oh, yeah, what are you thinking, man? Did you email me something, or? I don't know, man. I can't read your mind. Let me know. We'll do it if you got something. I'm looking for suggestions. I'm ready to go. I guess we do have a Mickey suggestion still on the table, so maybe we could do that. I'm just checking my email real quick, seeing if anyone sent me anything. There's been a couple times during the recent live streams where someone has emailed something and been like, "Hey, you're live right now. Will you do this?" And like, I don't check my email while I'm streaming. So I'm just trying to Make sure Mike didn't send me something on the secret horn. All right, cool. Yes, I think we should go back and do Mickey's suggestion. Mickey, you're right. Thanks for keeping me honest. I think that's a good idea. Let's see. Mike did just suggest something. Let's go watch it, as is customary. Mike, what'd you suggest here? I'm not sure, Mike. That break's kind of hard to hear for me. There very well could be another break in here, but I don't think I can do that one, man. It's just kind of like, you know, it's a tiny room. And there's like a banjo and stuff. Like, it's kind of hard to hear the guitar in that one. Sorry, Mike. I love you anyway. All right, let's go back to Mickey's suggestion. Okay, what was the name of that tune? Let's see if I can find it real quick. Yeah, Interstate Rag. Cool. There we go. Man, someone's computer is moving a little slowly today. I think we should do that first bit. I think we should definitely do that first bit. All right, cool. I don't even know the basic melody to this. We played this one time, Mickey. I think we did with Drew. We're in D. Cool. Da da da. Da. It sounded like da da. It sounded like that. Those are the notes I heard, at least. Yeah, of course. He probably does the rest of that up here too. I'm probably being silly. It sounds like he scoops into this and then he immediately plays that next time. So probably the same pickup again, but he's reaching for that next higher note. Da. Oh, and Mickey just said that he's playing it on the 7th fret of the D string. Thanks, Mickey. Mike, you can just ask Mickey if he has to have it. Mickey's right here. Da, do, da, da, do, da, do. So it sounds like this next note that's coming in is probably more like the dotted 8/16th kind of feeling. If we're trying to get specific. Kind of like this. Yeah, I feel that. This note lasts longer though, doesn't it? It definitely does. Because that is supposed to happen on beat 4. That's not exactly what I wanted to write out rhythmically. It's closer. Yeah. Let's ditch this. This is like confusing notation for the sake of confusing notation. This is much easier to read. Yeah. Cool. I know, I love this kind of stuff. You ever realize that this is really hard because you forgot to ever slow it down? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. This is cool. It's floating hard. I think that's it. I'm not sure I hear that second open E string. Let's go nice and slow. Let's go super slow. Let's try to hear if it's the open E string right there. I think he plays both B's right there, which would be like the coolest thing. Crazy. Yeah, that feels the most right to me for sure. Cool. Yeah, this is a weird lick for sure. Cool. Where's he slide up from? So from a fret below. So you're sliding it from six. Just some garbage, little time holder stuff. Hey, Theo. Da, bo, da. So my guys are concerned. On the beat now. Something like that. Da, ba, do, da, do. So like this much. Cool, 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 cool. A little hard to hear right there for a second. We're gonna go with this. We're gonna put both of these in parentheses because they're so hard to hear. See, getting another string to get 3 note grasp again. See what Mickey's talking about. I think he's just playing the same note. Maybe he's just playing the same note twice and he's just going back and forth like this. Thank you. Sounds like there's another note. Oh. I think that's just tied over. He doesn't actually play 7 on B1 right there. Mickey, what are you saying? Right, yeah, quarter notes, I got that. You did it. Yeah, I did. You're talking about this. Something like that. Three quarters and 2/8. Quarters, 2/8. Oh, this guy. I see what you're saying. I'm not sure this is actually quite that fast. I think it's this. Sounded like a double stop hammer on. Sounds like there's some garbage stuff, just placeholder strumming that could sit right there. Okay, so it's the beginning of this phrase. Scoot up. Minor third. This next one's on the beat. It's more like this. Oh yeah, all right. Sound like that almost. Okay, wait. It sounds, or it looks like he plays both B's, but I'm not sure I hear it. I think I just heard that. Measure 23, the slide, 23, oh, okay, yeah, let's see. Right, yeah. Don't worry, Pete, we got started late. Let's go real slow for this last bit. I'm trying to hear the qualities of the strings too. I think that's it. This is a lot to read. This is a ton to read. Let's get rid of the sheet music just so we can put it on the page. And why not give it a try? You know, we're here. Mickey, that's the whole thing, and that is my sight read too. I think it wasn't a very bad sight read. I feel pretty good about that one actually. That's a tough one, man. You pick tough stuff. Let's see. Let's label this correctly. We got Interstate Rag. Looks like the Gator Bone Trio. Cool, I can do that. We didn't do pick strokes, but it's a long one. I'll do the pick strokes later. Save your work. If you're working at home, save your work. Cool. Oh, long one. All right, I got to catch up on all these messages. I feel like I'm super behind for some reason. Tony Rice with a hangover. Probably not going to get to Dixie Darlin today. Maybe let's do that next stream. Just remind me, and I'll do it, man. Those are easy. We'll bust it out real quick next time. What else I got? Pete, I missed my chance to make a wish. I'm also in the wrong time zone. Mickey, you heard that double B string on the tag. Yeah, it's kind of a weird moment. I think I hear the open E string, but it looks like his hand is moving to that spot, like that B string spot. Anyway, maybe I'm crazy. Mike says, how about Texas Gales, Clarence White? We could do that. I think someone's already done that, though. Isn't there a whole book of Clarence White tabs for those, that album where he plays a bunch of different little snippets of tunes? A tab for Fair to Partly Cloudy by Chris Eldridge would be awesome. I don't even know that one. We'd have to go listen to that. Thanks for all the nice works, guys. Louisville, Kentucky. Can you do Tony's part on Nashville Blue? Nashville's Blue? Nashville Blues, perhaps? With J.D. Crow in the New South? New Chance Blues, Tony Rice. I don't have any of those. Those are all good Tony breaks to do. I want to check out this Partly Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs thing, Chris Eldridge. Here we go. definitely not what the tune is called. here we go. Well, here's a video of him playing it. I don't know if this is the one we want to use, but it's a video. Or are we still slow? We want to be normal speed. It's very pretty. It is very pretty and very cool. The only reason I'm nervous to do it is because afterwards that means I have to read it. It's really cool though. I don't know, how long have we been streaming? An hour and a half already? Okay, probably not gonna do that one because it'll eat up the rest of my time if I do that one. That's a great one though, man. If you suggest that one next time, we'll definitely do it. Also, maybe next time we'll do some yo-yoing. All right, let's see what the other things we got here is. Can you do Tony's part on? Oh yeah. Okay, we have a Nashville Blues. I got the blues. Leo says, could I transcribe a yo-yo video if I sent him one? That's a great question, Theo. Probably not. My yo-yo days might be far behind me. Okay, I think just by nature of time, this one's a little bit long. So I might have to give this one the no. Give it the next time. Let's check out another one of these. By the way, I'm really sorry, guys, if I don't get to your suggestion. I get to as many as I can every single time. I hope you all know that. But part of me picking them is like, you know, it feeling like the right time, me having enough time to actually get through the thing. It's a real bummer when I can't finish them on stream. That's a crazy break. This is like the weirdest Tony break ever. I might have to do this one. It's like putting in all the Tony Rice phrases. Crazy. Okay. Let's write this one down because it's too weird. It is a funny break. Oh, it's one of like these. One of these like climbing guys. I haven't even played my guitar yet. G. No, we're not. We're not a G. We're an A. Whoops. Tombstone Junction, Brian Sutton. I think I already have that one, man. If you send me an email, I think I might be able to send it to you. I think this happens over the bar line. Maybe I want to write it like this. I think that's the move. Actually, is that phrase okay? It's just, it's so funny. Sometimes I'm like, what is that? And then when I finally figure it out, I'm like, oh yeah, it's just the Tony Rice thing. And people are like, why can't Marcel hear what that is? I don't know, man. I wish I could tell you. I think he's just climbing that minor pentatonic box. Something like this. He did that funky note he likes to throw in. Thank you. I should just trust my gut more, man. It's so funny. Sometimes I'm like, oh, what is that? What is that? What is that? And it's like, oh, yeah, it's what you think it is, man. Just write it down. One more rest in there? I think so. Just doing like a real tiny band on that. And it just happened. I jinxed myself today, everyone. Today is the day that I jinxed myself. Guitar Pro just crashed. I was just saying today, hey, isn't it incredible that Guitar Pro has like never crashed on me? Isn't it crazy that this never happened like on stream or anything? I have such good luck with this program. And then today, today's the day the Guitar Pro crashed. See if we can bring it back up. I don't think I had saved that yet. That might be the premature end of the stream. This is an example of Tony completely inventing a tune with no melody but changing the history of bluegrass guitar at the same time. Yeah, you're right, Mickey. He's not really doing like... he's not doing anything of what's like expected of him. It's really neat. I love when he does stuff like this. Oh no, I'm not sure I'm gonna get it back. No, it's gone. It's gone for good. We have all the other work that we did today. We didn't lose any of that. We just lost this most recent one we were working on. Which I find very funny. No, the only autosave that I have is from super early on. I would just start from the beginning again. So that might be it, guys. We might just call it. I'm not sure I wanna go through it again. Let me listen to it again. You know what? I'm not a quitter. You guys might be quitters. You might quit on me. But I'm not quitting. I'm sure there's a lot wrong in here, but I'm just writing from what I remember. Something like that. There's my first mistake. And I remember this was kind of a weird number of rest, wasn't it? Let's bar arrange this verse. Right, I had two beats here, and then I had one more beat here. Da da do da. And look, we're right back where we were. Why would I be a chicken when I could just write it down again? This, you know, my old mind is like a steel trap. I remember everything I wrote down. Let's save our work, though, hey? Let's try to be good about that in case we crash again. New Chance Blues, Tony Rice. Surely that's worth something. My transcribing skills aren't totally useless. Look, I crashed and I got back to where I was. Down this path again. Let's just snag that, do a little copy and paste. Okay. Da da do da 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 boo da do da da bum. Something like that. He kind of flubs this hammer on right here. feel like this isn't working out timing-wise, like something got weird here. Maybe I just wrote something weird. Huh. It's like he's getting over to this F. But it feels like it takes him longer to get there. I wonder if there's just a little fumble. I hear something like that. Da 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 da. That's what I would do. Of course, that's not what Tony's gonna do. Alright, once again, if I had to wager on what he's gonna do next, I think it's gonna be that. Keep saving your work, people. Hey, what's up, Doug? We're just transcribing away here. Okay, so we're up the neck now. Some kind of like one of these kind of things. We'll fix all that timing. Yeah, totally cool. This just needs to be on this side of the bar line. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I don't think he came all the way down. I really don't think that he did. I'm gonna write it there anyway. We'll fix that later. Who suggested this one? I don't know who suggested this one, but I hope you're still here. Dean Daniel. Hope you're still here, man. I think all of this is the octave up, because I hear him do this like quick slide at the bottom of this, like he slides out. There's some position stuff that needs to be cleaned up in this for sure. Thank you, Mr. Martin. Yeah, we could do that one sometime, man. This is probably the last one we're going to do today, just because we've been going for a while now. We're just trying to wrap this up. Cool, and then we're at this repeater. Da do do da do do da do do da. Hey Peter. Hey Tom Jennings. He's doing that one Tony Rice lick, which is unironically frequently called that one Tony Rice lick. One more note. One note in, like, right there. Yeah, we're good. So I hit the wrong button there. Be that. You sound like that. He hits a funky note in there. I don't think he meant to, but it's super quiet in the background. Who knows? Let's skip over it. Alright, he's coming in off the beat. I guess that with the eighth fret. I accidentally wrote those too high. Keep forgetting where I am. He normally plays these licks kind of in a different spot. So it's making me kind of question what I'm doing. Right, these aren't straight eighth notes. He holds that note for longer. Okay, so then he just kind of like strums into this next thing. And as confirmed from what I said earlier, my count got off somewhere. Because this should be happening on B4 of this measure. so on and so forth, back to the beginning of time. I guess it could mean the whole thing just started on beat four and I didn't notice because it was so awkward. It does. I love when this happens to me, guys. When like I get to the very end and I'm like, oh, I made some crucial mistake down at the very beginning that affects the rest of the break. Yeah, right here, this is actually a pickup. Probably because I was listening to it slow, I didn't even notice. So this makes the whole thing work out. Yeah, yeah, cool. There we go. That was my problem. The whole thing's right. I just needed a pickup. Cool. Yeah, that means some of these little moments can be fixed too. This was like a tie going to a quarter note. It doesn't have to be now. I'm not sure. Oh, and this makes so much more sense with this ending on B3. I was concerned about that when I was writing it too. I was like, what's wrong? So it's good to get that figured out. This is where there's some messy position stuff too. Find out what the truth is right there now that I know. Oh, what's going on? What did I hit? There we go. I think it's just this. Yeah, I think he's just a little sloppy. This note ends up a little bit quiet. I think that's all it is. Okay, I don't have to listen to that super slow anymore. All right, you guys know that when I finish these, I normally read them. So there's no way I can get this on one page. I guess we can do it in a single scroll. So here's the first half. Oh man. Ending, Tony. Okay, there's kind of a slow side read. Yeah, this is the only part that I'm still thinking, like, man, how could you make that cleaner? But I guess you can't really, unless he did like an escape note right there, but I'm just not sure that he would. Who knows? But anyway, that's it. Let's put in the title. We'll just do the old Blake and Rice. There you go. Oh, guys. It's been a good one. We did a lot today. Maybe we did four today. That's good. I like that. We did some long ones, too. This was definitely a longer one. Took a little more thinking. Oh, man. Anyway, guys, I hope you got something out of this. I hope you like hanging out. If you got anything to get off your chest, you tell me now. It's time to stand up, get a stretch. Everyone stretch it out a little. I know, it's very Tony Rice Licks Mickey. It's like just all the classic stuff. Tony Rice, but with a hangover. You just got back, but it's the end of the stream. Well, yeah, we're just hanging out a little bit, but I will show you the what we ended up with here on New Chance Blues. I just played through it. It's a pretty crazy break, man. I imagine you'll probably watch this back and pause it so you can read some of this, but there you go. Hopefully this is enough for you to for you to get through it. It was a really cool one, man. Weird break. Thanks, Mickey. We got through it. We got through a crash and all. Actually, the crash wasn't even a setback. We wrote it down super quick after that crash. Hey, what's up, Rick? You're late. Yeah, hi, man. Thanks for stopping in anyway. We're just hanging out for our last minute here. We don't have a lot to say or anything. We're just relaxing. Yeah, it's nice with these new live streams. I don't know how you guys are feeling, but there was a couple of the early live streams where we tried to do a lot of pieces. Or rather, instead of doing a lot of pieces, we tried to do very long pieces. It seems like in the more recent ones, instead of doing these really long transcriptions, we're instead doing a bunch of small ones and we can fit in like four or five in the stream. And I think that's the way to do it. I'm kind of falling in love with that. I think that's the much more interesting way to do this whole process. But like always, eventually these tabs will be on the website. And by the way, if you had any troubles with the website is back and up. It's running. It should be faster than ever, so you shouldn't have any problems with that. Eventually, when I get these on there, I'm sure I'll post some kind of update. We do the stream highlights, of course. And what else do I got for you? I don't know. I'm not sure I have anything else for you. Thanks for hanging out, everyone. I think it might be time to say goodbye. I don't know what music I want to play, though. Do I want to do the Tony Lo-Fi, or do I want to do like the classic Beggar Boy Lessons with Marcel theme song? I think we'll go with the Tony Rice Lo-Fi. I've been digging that a lot lately. I'm sick of my own songs, you know? Just to the Tony Rice. Oh, whoa, apparently Lessons with Marcel is live. I should check that out. No problem, Dean. I'm glad you like it. If you email me, I'll send you a copy. Email me at help@lessonswithmarcel.com, and I'll get you a copy of what I just wrote down. Anyway, y'all, I'll see you next time. Y'all have a great evening.
So I'll do a count to lead it in. 1, 2, 3, 4... Tighter sound. The other instrument that I have is one that I've played, I think, more than I have any other. Now, the instrument is very well balanced. If it was a custom-made Ovation, if I were you, I wouldn't take a prejudice to guitars that have plastic backs. Tighter sound. Tighter sound. Tighter sound. It drifts away from the norm. Sounds very much like a dreadnought. Tighter sound. Very well balanced. There's some people that like a tighter sound. Things I should mention now is that, first off, neither the rhythm through there nor the improvising part over the rhythm were what I would